ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds for the Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Championship, powered by La Quinta Inns and Suites. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, he stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 146 pounds. He trains at Regulators Fight Team. Joining us from Iowa City, Iowa, Quinn Murphy. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, he stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 141 pounds. He trains at Far West Martial Arts and is sponsored by Yabba Dabba's House of Glass, 217 Flavor LLC, Elite Loyalty Management, Midwest Combat Club, and Tacos El Paisa. Joining us from Decatur, Illinois, Brynn, the Jedi Heathcock.
Here we go, Quinn Murphy, Brynn Heathcock, they touch him up. Straight left, left hook right there. Definitely on his wheels, looking for that takedown, expecting it. There's that level change. Left hand connects.
Nice trip. Had a Russian arm tie there.
Still locked onto that arm. Heathcock trying to defend, trying to get away, keep that distance. Knows what his opponent's after, and it's the takedown. Left hand from Heathcock. Leg kick into a takedown right there. Heathcock back to his feet. Quinn Murphy relentless, however.
Very good wrestling technique.
Heathcock defending up against the cage.
Inside trip coming maybe here.
1 minute down the first round. Ooh, overhand right from Quinn Murphy.
Murphy just walking him down.
He's got to watch it. You know, Heathcock's landing with those strikes. All it takes is one big right from Heathcock, and he can put him down.
Corner's telling Murphy, quit following him, meaning cut him off. Nice, clean takedown. Got to get off to the side.
Looking to get under the neck. Not much there. Quinn Murphy.
He's got the defense.
Very, very measured, calm, gets out.
Put him up against the cage here.
A minute plus to work here in the first round.
Corner saying, put him against the cage.
Murphy pulling that head down, has his right arm trapped. Heathcock has the right arm trapped.
The cage is definitely a wrestler's friend.
Looks like Quinn Murphy might actually let him up. Well, goes in the leg kick, now backing off. Another leg kick. Heathcock remaining composed on the bottom. Back into full guard. Has to watch it. Murphy posturing up right now. Right hands, left hands.
Go for the leg lock. Nice, he got his foot behind him.
Still looking at that ankle.
He's got to get his other leg behind him.
Oh, tried to lock it in, got out. 15 seconds to go in the first round. Big elbow from the top from Murphy. Right hand from Murphy. Ooh, shot from the bottom from Heathcock. Right hand from Murphy over the top. And we'll go to round two.
Murphy's standing up between rounds here.
Not a lot of emotion to read on Murphy's face.
It's right there.
Very stoic.
Yeah.
Here's some of the action from the first round. Right hand missing by Murphy over there. Heathcock with the leg kick. Eventually, this will be the first takedown from Murphy. Another takedown from Murphy. Posturing up, getting some shots in from the top.
Thank you for doing that, Jason. I was listening to Eric Koch give instructions about changing levels and bringing the punches over the top. Trying to get Heathcock to commit on dropping his guard and defending the takedown that's not actually happening and getting clipped, right?
Absolutely, and Heathcock has had some success on the feet. Ooh, big wild right. And there's a couple of lefts from Heathcock and a right. Now they're swinging. Murphy locks him up. This is playing right into Heathcock's game. Ooh, left hand from Murphy connects, however. Right hand from Murphy connects again. Knee from Murphy. Some body shots from Heathcock. No one's ever accused him of not having a chin. Left hand from Heathcock, almost into an ankle pick
from
Murphy.
That was a quick ankle, single leg snatch.
Left hand from Heathcock. Ooh, spinning back fist connects.
It rocked and his knees buckled.
Right hand. Coke is telling him he's got him hurt. Tell him to put him on him. Takes him to the ground.
Ankle pick.
2 minutes left in this second round right here. Murphy just where he wants to be by his coaches for instructions. Coach is telling him not to let him breathe. Murphy backing up. Leg kick from the top. Another attempt at a leg kick. Chance of let's go Murphy from the crowd. Heathcock back to his feet. Swinging with that left hand. Hands low.
Oh.
Into a takedown. Look for like for a second that he was going to go for that choke.
How tight is it?
Tough to say. It's arm in. It might be there. Nope. Gives up on it, head pops out.
He's tired, look at him. He was going for it, he was squeezing hard on that choke.
Murphy with a right hand from the top.
His guard's open, I mean, you can pass the guard.
I wasn't adjusting it. Heathcock adjusting those legs a little bit. Not much action from Murphy on the top. Looks like Heathcock's gonna make his way back to his feet. Left hand, left right. Ooh, big knee from Murphy. Swings for the fences and misses.
These guys are clubbing each other.
Yes, they are.
Heathcock's landed some good shots.
Those hands are low from Heathcock. Another spinning back fist attempt from Murphy. Had some success earlier in the round. Right hand from Murphy, left hand from Heathcock. Left right from Heathcock.
Holy cow.
Last 10 seconds, that's a tough one, you know. I'd probably end up giving it to Murphy because of the back fist
right. And
because of the control on the top. But Heathcock definitely probably landed more strikes there.
I think so.
Certainly a tough round to call. Again, a big, big, big spinning back fist in the beginning of the round.
Yeah.
Wasn't really able to capitalize on it. Had him in the right spot, had him in his coach's corner. Look at some of the action right here. Here's one of those left hands from Heathcock. Left from Murphy. Right from Murphy, left from Murphy. Body shot from Murphy, exchanging the body shots here. Looks like they're fighting in a phone booth right there.
Oh, it's like Don Fry in Japan. I can't remember who he was fighting, remember that?
Yeah, he recently passed his opponent. I forget who it was, but he passed, I think, just like last month. Asian fella.
Were you thinking of Inoki?
No, different guy. Inoki also passed.
Yeah.
Left hand from Heathcock. Murphy still pressing the action, coming forward. Left, right from Heathcock. Two right hands, land for Murphy. Now it's a right, it's a left. It's a left that hits him. Clean, that one hurt him. Another right, Heathcock. Another left.
Heathcock swinging back.
Yes, he is. What an exchange. Body shot from Murphy. Body shot again from Heathcock.
Heathcock's back looks like it's got
severe bruising.
Well, it's got
could be rash from the
from the cage.
Yes.
Grating across a cheese grater.
Left, right from Heathcock. Heathcock with a big breath. Murphy still pushing forward as he takes a left hand to the face. This is only round 3 of 5, folks. 1 minute down in the third round. Knee from Heathcock. Uppercut from Murphy lands.
Mouthpiece comes out.
Heathcock bites back down, and here they go. Left hand from Heathcock. Uppercut from Heathcock. Left, right from Heathcock.
He got rocked there. As he was going down, he went for the takedown. See if the judges recognize that as a knockdown. Because he hit his knees and then started scrambling for the takedown, it looked like to me. Hopefully we see that replay.
And now Murphy into side control. He's got his knee on that neck. Those knees to the side are wide open right now. They should be utilizing
them. Both guys are tired.
Very tired. Murphy remaining in control. Less than a minute to go in the third round. Coach is calling to elbows to the body. Few weak body shots right there. Coach is screaming about the open guard right now to Murphy. Heathcock with a couple shots from the bottom. What do you got for this round?
Close.
It's a close one. I would say if there was a round for Heathcock, this would be the one.
He landed a lot of shots.
He did. He did. And even in that last takedown, you could tell that Quinn Murphy wasn't quite as in control as he had been in the first two rounds. We'll see what happens in the championship rounds coming up, round 4 and 5. Here's some of the action. Left hand by Heathcock. Uppercut right hand by Heathcock. Right hand by Murphy. Another right. Murphy certainly had his moments here with this flurry. At the same time, Heathcock fought back. There's a big overhand left that sneaks through into another overhand left.
And Heathcock stepped back going, okay, just give me a chance to breathe here for a second.
And then another left-right, wild swing into the takedown from Murphy.
I will give Murphy this. When things are going a little off the tracks, he's pretty good at adjusting. He's a good enough wrestler where he can turn tripping over a parking block into a takedown.
Here we go, round 4, they touch him up. Murphy continuously being the aggressor, walking down Heathcock. Heathcock circling. Right hand from Murphy gets through, into a takedown. Heathcock looking at that neck right now.
Got nothing.
We're into side control, he's close to his coaches. They're calling for some pressure. Looks like those knees are wide open. Oh, looking to step over, doesn't quite make it. Coach is telling him to keep side control. Those knees are wide open. More chance of Let's Go Murphy. Our online polls have Murphy as the slight underdog right now at 45 and change. However, Heathcock really needs to rally if he wants to take this fight, either with a finish.
Trying an inverted triangle there.
Coach is calling for Quinn's legs to get higher. Now he's on side control. Murphy looking to take that back. Doesn't quite have a hook in, rolls. Half guard. Now into full guard. Heathcock looking exhausted on the bottom.
Both of them.
Yeah,
both
although you just saw that shot, that left-hand attempt, and even these body shots. Both fighters breathing heavy. Heathcock looking to possibly get that triangle. Not quite there, although he's able to bring that head down. Look for a possible transition into an armbar. Murphy said no dice. Short shots from Murphy, back into side control.
See, what I was talking about earlier with the vinyl, once you get sweaty, you can literally slip around like an eel and dart out from underneath people. Helped me considerably against Dan Severn.
Can't believe you fought Dan Severn in the first place. That's just so ridiculous.
Hey. And lock this on here.
Yes, he is. Not able to do so. About 10 seconds left in the fourth round. Looks like we're going to get into the fifth and final round. More than likely, Bryn Heathcock is going to need a finish. Both fighters taking some big breaths as they get up off the mat. Seems like Murphy's disappointed with that fourth round. Feels like he should have had more performance. Some of the action, there's an uppercut that got through. Right hand from Murphy, left hand from Murphy.
Murphy walking forward consistently, hitting the takedowns. You can see not a lot in the gas tank there.
No, sir.
And there's the slippery heel technique.
Slipped right out of there. And it looked like there were some real elbows that were available to Murphy, but like you said, both these guys so tired and so slippery on the mat. We'll see what happens in round five. I would imagine Heathcock wants to keep it on the feet and try for that big right hand to end this fight.
Ready?
And they touch him up last round. This amateur title fight. Murphy landed the right, left, left, right. Oh boy, he's unloading. Ooh, swings for the fences. Ooh, Heathcock catches him with the left. Now into the takedown.
Heathcock, good job, getting the underhooks.
Good knee from Heathcock as he defends.
He's a circle up defense, good.
Which he does. Maybe he can have an explosion of his own right now. He needs it.
He's punching hard.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised if that flurry cost Murphy big time. Trying to put it away. Gotta watch grabbing those cages. Left hand from Murphy. 2 minutes left in the fight. Uppercut. Left hand.
He's the following an uppercut or a knee after a jab because Murphy ducks straight down every time.
Ooh, left hand from Bryn Heathcock lands as Murphy's coming forward.
Ooh, directly against the knee joint.
And those are perfectly legal. Some MMA fighters frown upon those, but...
I don't think it's really a sudden explosive technique against the joint. That's career-ending stuff.
That's exactly. Khalil Roundtree received a lot of criticism from his recent win utilizing that technique in the UFC.
Hey, until it's illegal, it's legal.
That's right. Heathcock looking at that neck. Murphy not in any trouble.
Trying to go to the Numa Plata here. Nice job. Or a Goga Plata even.
Interesting.
Trying to get a shin bone underneath his neck.
Yep. A little Eddie Bravo action right here. He might be able to get the choke. It's late.
It's across his face.
It's not under the neck. Mr. Miletich is correct. Uncomfortable, almost like a neck crank, but not quite there. Still, he's pulling on that bad boy.
Gotta get his leg over the top now, the right one.
Murphy does a good job of defending. Heathcock not able to slide that under the neck. Shots from the bottom.
There you go.
Could be a Heathcock round. This could end up being a 3-2 fight. But I've got Murphy as the victor. All sorts of sportsmanship here at Caged Aggression after that 5-rounder.
Both guys wore each other out.
Absolutely. Quite the battle. Go to Jason Vargas to make it official. Quinn Murphy, Brynn Heathcock.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to our judges' scorecard for our decision. Our judges scored this contest 49, 46, 48, 47, and 49, 46, declaring your winner by unanimous decision and new Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Champion, Quinn Murphy. All right, we're here with your winner and new Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Champion, Quinn Murphy. Quinn, you asked for this title shot a while back, you got it. Wasn't exactly the fight you thought, but it was the outcome you wanted, man. Talk to us now about how that feels.
Yeah, it feels great. Sorry it was not as fun as usual, but we gotta get it done. Thank you. But, yeah, I wanted this fight, I got it, took advantage of it. Now we're here.
Yo, I know you're no stranger to Brynn's style or anything like that. Late switch up, was there anything that surprised you as far as this fight went?
Yeah, he's pretty tough. He's a lot stronger than I thought. He's a lot lighter than me, but he's really strong.
All right, well, you got the new hardware. Next step is defending it, but I know there's probably a little bit of after party action that we're talking about. Anything you want to say before we get to that?
Yeah. Thank you to my fans. They come deep every time. We can go tear up the city now, for sure.
Well, it's always a pleasure watching you perform. We're looking forward to the next one. But until then, like I said, enjoy this win tonight. You deserve it. Let's hear it one more time for your winner, ladies and gentlemen. New Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Champion, Quinn Murphy.